Hey everyone, today I want to talk about an interesting iOS interview problem I had a few months ago, and at the same time discuss a better way of implementing logging in our iOS apps. Now, most developers, myself included, tend to rely on using print statements to aid our debugging, but I want to show you how we can build a simple logging utility that's going to greatly increase our ability to debug our application more effectively. So let's talk a little bit about the requirements here. We know that a good logging utility would likely allow us to log events at different levels of severity. So let's go ahead and add that. So we're going to go ahead and create an enum. We'll call it log. And the first thing we know that we want to do is support multiple levels of severity. So we can go ahead and do something like log level. We can create a case for just something that's a simple output. We can create a warning case, and we can also create an error. So that's a good first step. But now we can imagine that as our application runs and we log more and more information to the console, it's going to get really messy and hard to read. So we know that in the case of a warning and an error, we'd ideally like to be able to easily see that in the console output. So let's go ahead and try and find a way to make that easier to recognize, you know, in a big log of text. One way we can do that is we can do something like this, right? Which is going to prefix all of the output of a warning or an error with an associated emoji. So it's just going to allow us to easily recognize these kinds of events in a larger log. All right, so this is a good start, but would likely need to provide some additional context about the issue that's happened, and would likely want to know the file, the function, the line, and maybe some additional context about the state that the app was in that triggered this warning or this error. So we're going to go ahead and create a struct that will store that information for us. We'll call it context, and it's going to have a few properties inside. We'll create one for file, which is going to be the file name, another one for function. We'll create one for line, which is going to be an int. And the final property we'll create is description. And this is the property that a programmer is going to use to provide more information about the state that the app was in before this warning or error occurred. So let's go ahead and create that here, and we'll go ahead and return this. So just for a little bit of context here, we're converting file to an NS string, which gives us access to this last path component property. And otherwise, file will be the entire file name, including the parent directory and everything above it. We really don't need that information. We just need the file name and the extension, and then we just need the line and the function. So that's why we've done it like this here. All right, so we are getting there. So let's focus now on writing the actual function that's going to be responsible for the logging. That's going to take this log level, this prefix, this context, all of this information, and actually format the output string that gets printed to the console. So I'll just go ahead and save you some time. This is what it could potentially look like. Feel free to make any changes here. But the idea is that we'll take in the log level, which will tell us the severity. It'll give us a string, so the main output to include, whether or not we want to include the context, so whether or not we want to include that additional information we found, and then the actual context that we can selectively include or ignore. And here what it's doing is it's going to go ahead and combine the prefix that we've already chosen, right? So it's going to be one of these options here, and then the actual string, and then it's going to selectively include the context information if it was requested to be included. And the important part here is that we're using preprocessor macros, which is a cool thing that Xcode gives you that allows you to selectively run code depending on the environment that you're in. So we might only want to run like very verbose logging while we're in debug mode. We likely wouldn't want to do this in a production application because it would slow things down. And it might also reveal aspects of our application that we don't want anyone else to see. So with this, we can ensure that this printing is only going to happen if we are running in development mode. All right, so now we're on the home stretch. Now we can create functions for info, warning, and error that internally call handle log. So one implementation could be something like this. Now, before we take a deeper dive into this, let me show you a feature of Swift called literal expressions. And the idea here is that anytime Swift sees this phrase, it's going to automatically replace it with a file name. Similarly here, it'll replace it with a column number, line, the line number, and function, the function that's calling the current code we're looking at. So back to this code, you can see that for the new info function we've created, the file name that we want it to print out, we're going to default it to the name of the file that's calling info. So for example, if we had home view controller and home view controller is calling log.info, file would be home view controller.swift, function might be home view controller dot view did load, and line might be 23. All of these phrases refer to the file that's calling this method. Now, you'll see that there's not a huge difference between info, warning, and error, except in that they each pass a different level down to handle log. And let's talk about handle log for a second. The reason that we've made it private is that we don't want to expose properties about how we're logging sensitive data in our application to anyone else. And one of the advantages here is that we can take this log enum and drop it into any other project we're working on, and it's good to go, right? And by revealing information about how this works to classes that use it, we're breaking a lot of basic programming best practices. So there's no reason for another class to know how this ought to work. It should just know how to use this API, and that should be sufficient. All right, so let's look at a practical example. In viewcontroller.swift, I'm going to go ahead and add one log of every type. And when I run it, you'll see that everything works as expected. So not only can we easily distinguish between info, warning, and alert logs, but we get all of the context information that we wanted. Now, hopefully you'll notice also that our API is fairly simple and concise, which means that we could easily take this log.swift class that we've built, enum, and bring it into any future project that we work on. And because the implementation is so simple and extensible, we can easily do things like have different logging behavior for different environments, for example, development, staging, and production, or we could easily add support for uploading all of these logs to the cloud. And I hope that you see also that this gives us way more granularity and control than using print statements ever would. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any video requests, please leave it in the comment section below. Otherwise, please like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks.